Salutations, respected viewers. Here I am at Liverpool Street Station, and here you can see this memorial to the Kinder Transport, as in children's transport. So in 1938 and 1939, about 10,000 children from Germany, Austria, and what's now the Czech Republic came here by train to a place like the Netherlands, and then shipped across the North Sea to the United Kingdom. They were Jewish children, and obviously they faced discrimination in Germany. It was the Third Reich at that time under the Nazi government. Austria united with Germany in March 1938. Then what we now call the Czech Republic was taken over by Germany in two stages, September 1938 and then March 1939. So these people were facing discrimination because of their ethnicity, to some extent because of their faith. So a scheme was arranged whereby these unaccompanied minors were permitted. Their parents were almost never allowed to come, and these children had sanctuary here in the United Kingdom, and they have well over 100,000 descendants around the world now. Here we are 80 years later. What else? So it's got the inscription "For das Kind" in German. I'm not sure, can you see it there? And then it's got the same in Czech, "Chodite." Can we get that angle there? "Chodite." It's got it in English on the other side, "For the child." So this little boy is wearing a yarmulke. He's a Jewish boy. Perhaps you can see that. And so many of them reached prominent positions in British life, or a chap who was a teenage refugee from Königsberg became the chief rabbi, Lord Jakobowitz. I'm trying to think who else there would be. The man who played Manuel in Fawlty Towers, forget his name actually. Tom Boer, his parents, that famous author, his parents came from what's now the Czech Republic. Lord Dubs, a Labour peer, and he brought in the Dubs Amendment, sort of allowing unaccompanied child refugees to be brought into this country. And when he died, David Cameron praised him, but now unaccompanied child refugees are not always allowed in. So that's it. They came to Liverpool Street Station because they came by ship from the Netherlands to this country, and then trains from the east coast of England usually came to Liverpool Street Station, brought up by Jewish families, by Christian families, and so on. So that's that, a fascinating thing about Liverpool Street Station, and an example of humanitarianism in this country. In most cases, their parents were killed in the Holocaust, and had these children not been brought here, most of them would have been killed.